Hello and greetings from Iceland. As to expect, I have plenty of news, and I can't say that things look good, so let's start with what we have been learning from our scientists, who have been rather busy recently. They seem to have located the center of landrise, and it is around here, by this 200 meter long row of craters, five craters, from one of the many 13th century eruptions on the peninsula. And we call this place Illahraunsgígar. It is a challenging name for the international media that might have to cover this location as a big story soon. And in this case, it's also a name that doesn't sound well to us Icelanders, since the name Illahraunsgígar means evil lava craters. So what we have here is a lava field called evil lava, and it surrounds a big part of the Blue Lagoon, which is only 900 meters away from the craters. So this place might turn out to be the epicenter of all things to come now. And when I heard about this location last Saturday, I took off to this spot. The conditions for a thermal drone could have been better, but I didn't mind. I wanted to see if the thermal drone could detect anything there, especially since this location is above the lava sill that's been forming around there. I started the scan around here and worked my way to the craters, and it didn't take me long to find at least one spot near them with obvious heat signal that I confirmed with a low pass to make sure. But as for the main craters, I wasn't sure this time. There were some signals that I could detect, but they could have been heat radiation, since we had some sun earlier that day. But when I was scanning, it was no sun and cold, like 3 degrees Celsius. So let's swap to the other drone now for the wide angle on which side of the craters it comes up. That will be the deciding factor when it comes to the lava flow. Lava could easily take off to the Blue Lagoon, but the eruption would have to be quite large to pose danger to the village Grindavík, so this is not the worst case scenario for them, unless it would turn out to be a long fissure. But what worries me the most now is that we have this well-known Icelandic volcanologist, and he has been saying that the magma there could contain a lot of gas that would generate extreme lava fountains, especially when the eruption starts. The maximum lava flow from previous eruptions on the Reykjanes Peninsula reached perhaps 40 cubic meters per second, but around there it could be hundreds. And the worst case scenario, according to him, from the news this morning, is that lava could hit the Blue Lagoon in 3 minutes after the eruption starts. And that is such a story that I'm finishing the video with that one, and those 13th century craters might be the reason for this dark forecast. They are called eldvörp, that means flamethrowers, so it was definitely not a tourist eruption back then. And of course we don't know how long fissure to expect there, nor the location. What scientists know for sure is that there is still inflow of magma, the land is still rising, so with each day passing, the eruption get larger, at least when it starts. So this looks more and more like this is going all the way. But back to my thermal drone. My most important finding from last Saturday might be a fumarole that I found around here, and I've actually been scanning this part ever since I came to Reykjavík, since I found some anomalies straight away the first evening. But what I came up with last Saturday was steam coming up from the ground, so I didn't need a thermal video to confirm what it was. From my limited knowledge, this looks as a new fumarole. It doesn't look as it's been steaming there for a long time, but there might be viewers that can help me with that. And I want to make it clear that I'm of course reporting all my findings, making my footage available, and the communications that I've been having with some of our institutions are actually good material for a separate video. But I don't have time for that now. I took off again there yesterday, and the earthquake started strong that morning. Most of them took place further west by the eldvörp craters, but while I was sitting there in my car scanning this area again, it was a 3.5 that struck almost directly under my car, and I was not amused. And there was actually an earthquake swarm going on for an hour or so by Thorbjörn, just below the webcams. And by the way, I'm leaving links to all the webcams that I know of. And I have found anomalies there at this location ever since the first scan there. And the scanning conditions were excellent yesterday, so I noticed this lineup now. This is the fumarole that I found the day before. And yesterday I noticed even more such spots. For a while I thought that they were all new, or those that are closer to the power plant. But when I looked back at the thermal video from last Friday, the lineup was present back then, but not as obvious as yesterday. So it's the conditions that have a lot to do with the results. I also found quite strong heat signals around 500 meters from the Blue Lagoon. I thought I had a new finding there, but again, looking at the Friday footage, I could see a little part of the hotspot in one of the videos, but it was way harder to notice it back then, so the Sunday scan delivered me first and foremost a cleaner thermal image of the area. So I will continue to go up there and scan, or until I think it's too dangerous. And yesterday, evacuation plans for the town Grindavík were made public, meaning that scientists believe that the risk is more than ever before. This is the first time that we see precautions of this level. We didn't even see such precautions in 2021, 22 or 3 before the first three eruptions. Even though the earthquake situation got way worse back then, I'm not sure if we have learned a lesson. Some of the responses I'm reading about now looks as this is eruption number one, and this is for the first time that the power plant is at risk. But in fact, this is magma intrusion number 5, and I can only say now that people are being prepared for the worst case scenario. This will, however, not affect the metropolitan area. The Reykjanes Peninsula has its own grid when it comes to hot water, but the hot water is the main problem. And this morning we just learned that the diesel generators have been placed in Grindavík, so things are getting very serious. And as for tourism, an eruption there should not interrupt international flights, since the airport has its own backup systems. We do not expect ash clouds to interrupt flights, unless we would get a long fissure that stretches all the way into sea, which is highly unlikely. So like during the last three eruptions, I don't think that tourists will run into problems. This will only affect a little part of the peninsula, so it's no reason to change your plans. But the Blue Lagoon still remains open, and it is not just a surprise to me. It's also a surprise to the tourists who know what's going on, and the tourists that booked in the last days and didn't get any notifications about the underlying risk. So I've been getting questions from viewers regarding that, and all I can say is that personally I think they should close this place now. And every day with magma inflow like it's now, it's making the eruption into even bigger flamethrower, perhaps less than a kilometer away from the Blue Lagoon. There is a ticking time bomb there, and we don't even know the exact location. So things are extremely hectic right now. I will do another thermal scan today or tonight, and I've been shooting a lot of other footage there, and only been using a little fraction of my videos so far in the updates, and actually shooting so much that I need to get myself another external hard drive, since I've been also testing a 360 camera on the car to show you around, and hoping to find time to edit some of that, to explain the landscape on the peninsula even better. And I have been here in Reykjavík now for 6 days covering this with everything else on hold, and it looks as I won't be going home soon. So I want to say thanks to you who have been supporting my work here. It's a whole lot more to the story than I've been saying in this update. My thermal footage has gone places, and it was in the news yesterday, but I found myself forced to go that way to get some responses from a certain institution. So I've not just been busy making videos, but make sure that it's seen where it should be seen. Since I'm the only guy in Iceland flying a thermal drone around there, to the best of my knowledge. And in my opinion, it has already proven to be extremely useful. So again, thanks to you who shared this vision with me, and pitched in for this investment that made the headlines yesterday, although it wasn't for the reason that I wished for. So will I have some strange side stories to this event soon? I sure do. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.